those are new areas or more emerging areas that are a little bit different from traditional wood science and technology, but these are emerging areas where we really need students and brilliant students like you guys to, you know, to come in and do research with faculty. So there are other programs also, but if you go to the Society of Wood Science and Technology website or the Forest Product Society website, these are two largest international organizations there that cater to the forest products industry, then you would be able to find all this information. Okay. Most of these universities basically kind of started with traditional forest products program. But recently, I think in the last 5 to 10 years, we are starting to move from traditional wood science into more diverse and broader programs. Okay? So, for example, North Carolina State. We were wood and paper science department. We have two different programs. One in wood science and one in paper science and engineering, two different programs. However, in the last couple years, we've changed into the Department of Forest Biomaterials. And why is that? That is because we are moving, you know, not from, but we are actually trying to capture a broader area where wood is being utilized, right? So wood is not only traditionally utilized for secondary manufacturing like furniture and cabinets and so on and so forth, but now we are using it for biofuels, for example, right? Cellulosic biofuels, you can use like the waste wood, or you can, you can use all kinds of any kind of, material that can go into landfill, sawdust and so on, to produce biofuels. And so that is one area of research that we are also engaging in. And so we have created a broader program at North Carolina State that captures this, okay? Michigan State, for example, we were talking recently about, we were just talking about the fact that the traditional wood science program has kind of moved into packaging, in the area of packaging and in the area of construction management, because in both of these areas, you're actually using wood, if you really think about it. Packaging, you know, paper, you can do paper packaging, you can also do wood packaging in the pellet market and so on and so forth. And so that is an emerging area. The other area that I was just talking about is construction management. We have all heard about green buildings. You know, even in India, you know, ITC Windsor, for example, you know, it is a green building. It is a, they are basically saying that, you know, everything that is here is green, and a lot of people are moving towards that. So that is another emerging area that is quite, you know, that a lot of students are very interested in and can find really good careers in that. Similarly, you know, the other universities, you know, are also moving towards a broader area than traditional wood products. For example, University of Minnesota, their program is now, instead of wood science and technology, their program is now known as bioproducts and biosystems engineering. So they are including everything that is bio, that, you know, wood is a renewable material. You all know that, right? It's a renewable, is it a green material? It's a green material, right? So this particular material can be utilized in many different ways, okay? And so we are considering it a bio-based material. And so wood, you know, you utilize bamboo. Bamboo traditionally was known as a plant. At least I considered it a plant, but then now we are including it within wood science, okay? So we are actually becoming broader than smaller, but then there are more opportunities for students in that particular area, because now instead of going traditionally in wood chemistry or wood physics, you know, give people some kind of a background in that, and then students can move into more broader disciplines like business, or you can move into and just do industrial engineering, or you can do just packaging management, or you can do construction management with a basic background in wood. Okay, so that's where basically I think we are moving towards. And I would like to welcome anybody else who actually knows more about this, or at least would want to comment, Pascal or Howard or anybody else, Sangeeta, if you guys want to comment on anything, please jump in, okay? So traditional disciplines within schools, within the different programs that we had, that we have in the US, normally focus in general on engineering and then on construction engineering, okay? And that's because what I talked about was, you know, it's very different the way the houses are built, not only residential, but also the commercial properties. The frame is all wood. So 90% of what you find among the frames is wood in the United States. Not here, but it's very different from here, okay? So in the US, you know, you could go into general engineering or you can go into construction engineering. Then there's manufacturing. Manufacturing and machining, which is basically you can manufacture glue lamp, or you manufacture any kind of other composite products, okay, plywood and MDF, or you can manufacture look at manufacturing of furniture or cabinets. So any of those kind of secondary products. So you can go into that area, and then design and craftsmanship. This has been there for a long, long time, and I think. It's still quite popular, I think, in the designing using wood. It's still a very popular area, but traditionally, we have focused on that. A lot of programs are moving away from craftsmanship, which is basically woodworking. Okay, but it is in some way, either through internship or through some kind of a summer program. We still have it at some point. Just doing designing and craftsmanship for the. In the wood science area. Physics and mechanics of wood, trying to look at the statics and mechanics, looking at the strength of wood properties and how that changes, with different temperature and pressure conditions or, other kind of conditions that you introduce. Anatomy and chemistry has been very, very traditional. I'm sure that a lot of, I looked at some of the posters there and a lot of people are working in that particular area here also. And then business marketing has been traditionally there as a side area. Now it is becoming quite huge because a lot of students are interested in coming in and starting their own business in the wood science area. For example, wooden toys is a small niche market in the US and also internationally. And so a lot of people are interested in starting their own business. And so entrepreneurship and the business side of things are coming up. A lot of employers come in and ask us about softer skills like business because students, you can learn how to do, how to basically make a product stronger with a basic wood background when you are going out to work in a company. But these softer skills are something that are not really being taught to the students very well in various programs, and so that's one area that the employees really need the students to have expertise in, okay? Analytical and marketing skills. And so traditionally, these have been the disciplines within the schools. Let's look at what is it changing into. Here's also some of the traditionally taught courses or research areas. So what I basically did was I went through all the universities and I kind of looked through what are the areas that are being taught, what are the courses that are being taught at the universities. So you would see wood physics is something that is very common. It's taught in almost every single program that is focused in the wood science or forest products area. Wood anatomy and chemistry, wood mechanics, wood products manufacturing processes, wood composites. Wood product statistical processes, where you learn about what kind of statistical processes and how that affects improvement of a product in a production environment. Quality control and facility management. So if you are a facility manager, for example, in the furniture industry, how would you manage the facility? How would you manage people? How would you manage the quality of products that come out? You all know that that customer is probably the most important person, because if they reject a product, then the company is not going to go anywhere, right? So controlling the quality 99%, 99.997% is very, very important, and that's being taught here in quality control. Wood products, business and marketing, again, focusing on the marketing side of things. Computer controlled wood processing, where CNC routers, the use of that in different type of secondary wood products industry or composite wood industry is something that is also traditionally taught. And advanced wood processing and machining, machining of wood, for example, with the knives that actually cut the wood, how does that affect the wood quality and what you get out of it. These are some of the traditional courses that were taught, okay? So here's what are the emerging courses or the new courses that are being taught or are being developed now based on the demand internationally, okay? I'm mostly in the US, but also, internationally or globally, here's where the focus is going. So this is also true for research areas, the areas of research that we endeavor in, that we go into, for our undergraduate researchers as well as mostly for the graduate researchers. mostly now it's being focused on application-based, okay? It's, for example, environment. We all know that the green movement, and we saw yesterday in several presentations, people have been talking about the, you know, how consumers have this positive image for the, you know, they want to create the least impact on the environment, right? And so this emerging green movement is starting to really move some of the traditional forest products industries also, as well as, you know, other industries, like other companies, like big box retailers like Walmart and, you know, other powerhouses in the United States. What they want is for students to have skills on understanding of environmental tools, okay? So environmental tools, for example, how can you calculate the environmental impact of, say, a package, of a paper package, right? Of a milk carton package, versus, you know, any kind of other product like a furniture, a piece of furniture, all right? So the tools that are being utilized are now starting to be taught to the students, because we can already see that a lot of employers are asking for it, okay? They're asking the students. So I don't know how many of you have heard about life cycle analysis, right? So utilizing the tools, you know, the software, and really understanding it is starting to really take hold, and a lot of these different programs are starting to bring that out, okay? In their different programs, we have started a program, we've started a course in life cycle analysis where we teach the graduate students, this is only a graduate level course, we teach the students, you know, how to use life cycle, how to use different types of softwares to calculate, look at environmental impacts. And then, for example, you know, green construction and design. That's also another area that is really starting to take hold in different programs. I know I was just talking to Pascal about the fact that they have 800 students in their construction management course. So there are a lot of these students go into go and work with big builders and large construction companies. Okay. The green building market is huge. It's not only growing in the United States, but it's growing in countries like China and India and a lot of other developing nations. So, you know, that's an emerging area that you guys can think about if you really are interested. And the other area is, and I'm talking about all kinds of application-based, and this is what employers are looking for, okay? The other one is quality control and Six Sigma tools, okay? Have you guys heard about Six Sigma? No? What is Sigma? Does anybody know what Sigma is? It's variation in the processes, right? So you have, you know, if you go into a production environment, you see that, you know, you have 100 pieces of furniture that is being produced every day, right? So what you want is that at the end of the day, every single piece needs to follow a quality system where the customers are accepting it, okay? So that's, you know, so we teach students about different types of tools that will help them, help to control the quality within a production environment, and that's what a lot of employers are looking for, and this is, you know, also lean manufacturing and waste management and so on and so forth, to cut the costs within the environment has become very important from the employer side, and that's something that we are bringing out. Sales and communication tools, and you wouldn't think that this is within wood products, but this is happening. We are starting to create applications for mobile phones so this is one area of research, and what we are trying to do is we are trying to see if we can create like different types of applications in mobile phones that people can start to use, you know, to know more about wood, to create more, to promote the awareness of wood as a green material. Okay. Bioenergy and bioplastics manufacturing and technology, that's also another area of research where, you know, wood plus plastics, you know, and looking at that, it's manufacturing and its technology. I mean, wood plastic composites is one, just one example, but that's also one area of research. Bioenergy, of course, is, you know, most of the programs now are doing a lot of research and have programs where we teach students about different type of processes that can, you know, thermochemical and biochemical processes for converting, you know, biomass into bioenergy. So that's another area. Innovation and design. And that's, you know, again, design is very, very important, and what kind of innovation you can do, you know, within the wood products within the wood products industry. That's another area that employers are looking for, and that's, you know, also something that we are teaching at this point. Starting to teach at least look at that sustainable housing and construction. How can you maintain the sustainability of the resources? How can you track products? Using certification systems, you know, that's becoming important. And I talked to one of the exhibitors here, WWF. If you have not been there, you should go and talk to those people, because they're starting to promote FSC, and they're saying that there are all these companies from India that are talking about how they need, you know, they need FSC certified wood. And so that's another area that that's also coming up, not only in the US, but internationally throughout. And then global trade. We all know that it's a flat world, right? Now, whatever happens in one side, you know, one part, a small part of one country affects another country, right? All these manufacturing taking place in China, they buy, you know, or all these manufacturing taking place in India, you know, a lot of times these are being exported to other countries, right? So whatever happens in one side affects the other side. So how do you treat this global, look at the global markets and what you should keep in mind? You know, all that is being taught in global trade. I teach a course in sustainable global trade, where we talk about the Lacey Act, you know, how that has affected importers and exporters in different countries, and illegal logging, and we talk about how do you look at markets, how do you come up with different strategies in different markets, and so that's another area of expertise that we need students to go into. So emerging disciplines, I've kind of talked about it. I'm just going to put it in here. These are the areas, and so what, you know, if anybody is if any of you are interested in talking to me or Pascal or other people who are doing research in the United States about different programs, you're welcome to come in and spend some time, you know, talk to us or send me an email. You know, I would be very happy to help you. But these are, you know, some of the emerging careers. You know, design engineers, database, decision sciences, very, very important. You know, if you can look at a company's data and tell them about what's, you know, who are their most loyal customers versus who is not, how much money are they going to be making, forecast that. You know, all that is starting to become important, okay? So what I want to say is that there is a lot of opportunities in different areas within the forest products industry. You don't have to think that you have to be a manufacturer or you have to be an engineer to... there are other areas also that you can diversify into and kind of go into, okay? So where the jobs are, I did a big research, before I came here, kind of looked through almost all the websites to look at, in the US, where are jobs? And you would see that some of them are not related to forest products industry, but I still wanted to throw it out there because you can create some kind of innovative area within that particular, industry. For example, healthcare. And you would say, what do we have to do with healthcare, right? So one of my students is doing research on prosthetic limbs using wood, right? So you can get into that. So this is a so healthcare is a big and emerging area internationally, and that's one area that you guys can go into. Consulting, business development specialists, clean environment, financial modeling, advanced medical research, digital and data management, automotive, green, energy efficient, you know, all of these areas are open to wood science students also. Other than, and this was a study that was done by Goldman Sachs in 2010, where the jobs are, you know, federal government, state government, you all know that a lot of people are going to, from the United States, the baby boomer population is huge. A lot of people are going to retire from the state government and the federal government. It's going to open up a lot of jobs over the next 10 years or so. Private environmental consulting or management firms, data management firms, new startup forest-based companies, you know, even traditional companies like Georgia Pacific, Weyerhaeuser, you know, all of these companies are very, very open to students coming in with diverse skills. I think this is my last slide. But opportunities for graduate research, I'll tell you right now that if any of you are interested in coming in and doing graduate research, you should contact your faculty within your area, go to their website of the particular program and look for faculty members who work in your area of interest. Contact them. Normally, we offer 100% assistantships, at least at North Carolina State University, or even like part-time assistantships to the students to come in and do research. We also have unique distance-based programs. I think almost all the different programs within the United States have started some kind of distance-based courses or distance-based programs, so the students can do it even from India. I did have a couple students from India. In the last 3 years, I've had two students from India who have taken distance courses and have done masters distant with us. cross-disciplinary subject. So you can do wood science and mechanical engineering. You can do wood science and business management. You can do wood science and, you know, packaging management. You can do like both, you know, do a minor in one or major in one and all that. That's also available. Different type of exchange programs, we also offer that with universities in Europe. And I think in India also, I think there is some kind of exchange program that SUNY is doing with an Indian university, so you can look at that. Extension and teaching opportunities are also available, you know, apart from research opportunities for the students.